chapter 14, Mishnah 4. The Mishnah discusses another case of an overhang. An overhang encircles a house and overlaps 3 finger breadths above the doorway, but does not extend over the rest of the doorway. Thus, there are 2 ohalim here. The house and doorway are 1 ohel, and the overhang around the house is another ohel. However, these 2 ohalim do not connect properly, since in general, 1 ohel does not connect to another ohel unless they overlap by tefach, which equals 4 finger breadths. These overlap by only 3 finger breadths. The Mishnah states the law for this house. If there is tuma, such as a piece of corpse inside the house, utensils that are under any part of the overhang are tame. Since the overhang serves the house, it is considered an extension of the house, and thus tuma spreads from the house to the part of the overhang that overlaps the doorway, and from there to the rest of the overhang around the house, since the overhang is all 1 ohel. The Mishnah discusses the reverse case. But if there is tuma under the overhang, the law is subject to a dispute. Rabbi Eliezer rules that the contents of the house are tame, because the tuma spreads from under the overhang into the house. Even though the overlap is less than a tefach, Rabbi Eliezer holds that just as a narrow overhang is considered to be 1 tefach wide, as we learned in Mishnah 1, so is an overhang shorter than a tefach considered as if it is a tefach long. Thus, the 3 finger breadth overlap is considered as though it were a full tefach, and it transmits the tuma from under the overhang into the house. But Rabbi Yeshua rules that the contents of the house are tahor. According to Rabbi Yeshua, an overhang that is shorter than a tefach is not treated as if it were a full tefach. Therefore, tuma cannot travel from the overhang to the house, since they overlap less than a tefach. A similar case. And the same law applies to a courtyard surrounded by an awning. If a house has a courtyard that is covered with an awning, and the awning extends only 3 finger breadths over the doorway of the house, the previous rulings apply. If a piece of corpse is inside the house, tuma spreads to underneath the awning. If a piece of corpse is under the awning, according to Rabbi Eliezer, the house becomes tame, but according to Rabbi Yeshua, the house is tahor.